Hello, I am Anshul from GoFodoo.com and welcome to this video on boats and streams from time, speed and distance. There is this very interesting concept at the end of the video. Don't miss it, guys. So here we go. Your speed is your speed on still ground, and speed of boat is speed of boat in still water. Obvious, right? Your speed, your own speed, will be the speed with which you can run when no other external factor is acting on you. So speed of boat will be boat speed in still water. Then there is speed of stream, the speed with which the river flows. Now when the boat flows in the direction of river current, we say that the boat is going downstream with a speed downstream. When it goes opposite to the river flow, we say it is going upstream with a speed upstream. Let's understand upstream and downstream in detail. But before that, interesting news. I am taking up request for the next video that you want. Mention the topic in the comment saying, I want GoFodoo's video on so and so topic. If you really want it, you'll make sure that format is this. Back to the topic. A river is flowing with a constant speed and a boat is rowing in the same direction with its own constant speed. Now, just like the case of man running on the top of train, these speeds, speed of river and speed of boat, will add up. And to a person standing on the bank of the river, boat will appear to go with a speed downstream, which is equal to speed of boat plus speed of river. Now, why will these speed add up? Because the river is pushing the boat forward. See, the river is flowing with its own constant speed. The boat is rowing on the top of the river's surface. So the river is pushing the boat forward with its own speed. So both the speeds, the speed of river and speed of boat, will get add up. Okay. In second case, when the boat goes against the flow of river, when the boat is going upstream, the reverse speed will counter the boat's speed. Okay. Reverse speed will oppose the boat's speed. So boat's effective speed upstream will decrease now. And speed of boat upstream will be speed of boat in still water minus speed of river. That's it. These two equations, 1 and 2, are all you need in this topic. Okay. While solving questions from this topic, we will assume speed of boat and speed of river as SB and SR. And wherever we get speed downstream and speed upstream, we'll replace them with SB plus SR and SB minus SR. Okay, so we will always try to assume variables for boat's speed and river's speed, and we'll try to eliminate speed downstream and speed upstream wherever we can. Now solve this question. Speed of boat is given to you as 13 km per hour and speed upstream is 11.5 km per hour. What will be the speed downstream? Pause and think about it. Speed upstream is less than boat's actual speed because river's opposite flow will be countering it. Okay, so river's speed will be 13 minus 11.5, that is 1.5 km per hour. You can get it from this second equation as well. Now for speed downstream, we have to add boat's speed to river's speed. That will be 13 plus 1.5, 14.5 km per hour. So these are the values that we have got for speed upstream, speed of boat and speed downstream. Now if you haven't noticed already, let me break it to you. These speeds are and will always be in arithmetic progression, with the common difference being the speed of river. Keep this in mind. This is very important. Speed upstream, speed of boat and speed downstream will always be in arithmetic progression. Okay. Next, we have a result that we can get from these two equations. very important result. Add equation number 1 and 2 and we will get speed of boat as speed downstream plus speed upstream upon 2. Now instead of adding, subtract equation 2 from 1 and we will get speed of river as speed downstream minus speed upstream upon 2. So in short, we have 4 parameters: speed of river, speed of boat, speed upstream and speed downstream. And if any 2 out of these 4 parameters are known to us, then we can very well calculate the remaining 2. Okay. Now we have one last question or a pointer, important point or concept to remember. In still water, speed of Zen's boat is S Zen and speed of Paul's boat is S Paul. So these 2 speeds given to us are speed of these boats in still water. Now in case 1, Zen is going upstream and Paul is going downstream. In case 2, Paul is going upstream and Zen is going downstream. And distance between them in both the cases is same. Now my question is, will the time they take to meet be same for both the cases? For case 1 and case 2, will the time they take to meet be same? Irrespective of their individual speeds, irrespective of S Zen and S Paul, whatever their values are, will the time they take to meet be same for both the cases? And if yes, then why? Well, logic is simple. In both these cases, their relative speed of moving towards each other would be same only. Because while calculating relative speed, the speed of the stream would get cancelled. For case 1, calculate speed upstream for Zen and speed downstream for Paul. Add these speed to get relative speed as they are moving towards each other. So we'll add their speeds to get relative speed. Now do the same for case 2. Okay? And you will get same relative speed in both the cases. And as distances are also same, the time taken both ways will be same only. I hope this concept was clear to you, and I also hope that you liked this video. Check your knowledge by solving the quiz given in the description below. And if you like the video, if you really like the video, then please give it a huge thumbs up. Subscribe and hit the bell icon so that you get notified when the next helpful video is out. Post your doubts, queries and feedback in the comments or mail them at support@gofodu.com. Thank you.